Hi students, let us come to the next topic, that is a memory transfer. So actually a memory transfer means we are transferring the data from one device to another device, that may be reading or writing. Okay, so the memory transfer can be, it has two memory operations, that is the two memory operations are So the two memory operations are read, write. So these are the two memory operations that are there. So actually a transfer of information, let me write that point. Transfer of information from memory to outside environment. If you want to transfer the data from memory to outside environment, this you call it as a read operation. Suppose if you want to send any data to the outside, means if you want to see that on the monitor, or if you want to see the information on the screen, so whatever that you are seeing, that is your reading, that is appear, whatever that appears on the screen, that you are able to read. So that you call it as a read operation. Transfer of information from memory to outside environment is called a read operation. Whereas transfer of new information to be stored into the memory is called write operation. Okay, so write operation means if you want to store some data in the memory, you are supposed to write that information into the memory. So that operation you call it as a write operation. Reading means just whatever that is there in the memory, we are reading. If you want to add a new information, that information has to be write to the memory. So that you call it as a write operation. So symbolically, the memory word is represented by M. Memory is represented by M, whereas the address represented in brackets. Okay, so let me explain the read and write operations. Read and write operation can be stated as for read, whatever that is there. So memory, this is address. So whenever the address is present within the brackets, that you call it as a content, means the data. So whatever the data that is present in the address register, that data will move to the data register, means that data will store in the data register. So you are just already presented information is moving to the data register, that you call it as a read operation. Means you are not adding any new information, new data. You are just reading whatever the data that is present in the memory into one register. Whereas write means, so whatever the data that is present in a register, that is written into the particular memory location. So suppose this is a memory location. So memory location is divided into number of slots. Each holds the address. So register contains some data. That data has to be moved to some particular address. So M of AR0, M of AR1, M of AR2, like that. So whatever the data that is present, that has to be write in the memory. So you are storing a new data into the memory. So storing a new data into memory, you call it as a write operation. Okay, that is a read and write. So let me explain more clearly. Suppose this is a processor. Okay, and here a memory will be there. This is a memory. So this processor and memory will be communicated with the help of bus. So bus holds all the control lines, address lines and data lines. Memory and processor is communicated with the help of the bus. So in the processor, you are having arithmetic logic unit, control unit. At the same time, you are having some registers. Here I am writing as a big, but the register is a small chip. For your understanding, I am writing register. So in this register, you are having address register, data register and control register. So actually the register is nothing but a storage device, a temporary storage device. Register is temporary storage device. Storage device or storage unit. So the processor means the ALU access the storage, temporary storage device, because this is a fast device. Whatever the data that has to be calculated, that has to perform the operation, that will be stored in the register. So the processor will take the data from registers only, not it take directly from memory. So whatever the operation that has to be performed, that operations will send to the processor, and those will be stored in the registers first. So the processor will take the data from registers and perform the operation, again sends that information to registers only. Then the registers will send through bus to the memory. Okay, so this is a operation how it done. So actually, let me take first read operation. Read operation, what it has to be do? Read operation means data register, whatever that content will be there, that is based on the data register. So already the memory contains in some particular address 2000, some 20 data is there. That has to be moved to the first the address register here in the processor holds next address of data to be executed. Okay, so first the address register goes to contains the 2000 address. So the controller passes to that 2000 location and takes already presented data, okay, that to the sent through the bus and to the register and stored in data register. Now the data register contains the 20. So whenever it stores 20, it increments to the next address, whatever the data that should be executed. So address register will increment it to next location. So now data register is 20. So with the help of the control signal, the processor will execute the operation. Suppose it do some operation, increment operation, 20 plus 20, 40 is there. So again the 40, the result will send to the memory through the bus, and it stores in somewhere in memory location. So here we are writing a new data. So this you call it as a write operation. So write operation means, so whatever the data that is a 40, that should be write to the content of memory location, MAR, means to that address location. Suppose this is a 3000 like that. So in that suppose not 2000 file, suppose. So in that address location, the data has to be moved. So whenever you are writing a new data, that you call it as a write operation. Whenever you are reading that information to the processor, that is a read operation. Okay, read means in the particular address location, whatever the data that is present, that moves to the data register in the CPU. After performing the operation, so the data register holds some register, means the result will store in some register. That data will stored in content of memory address register in some address. Okay, so this is the write operation and this is the read operation. Okay, this is about the memory transfer. Thank you.